In this video, I will develop a real GUnit test that uses a web driver. Here I have something prepared that looks similar to the output of the ID in the last video, but I extended it a bit. Here is a global variable called browser, where I can specify the browser I like to use for the test. And here in this method, based on the browser, I specified the regarding drivers instantiated. So when I picked Firefox, and a Firefox is instantiated, and if I pick Chrome, a Google Chrome will be instantiated, and Chrome will be used for the test. Here I will include the test itself, and here those method looks like before it shuts down the driver. Now I will prepare, I will test the autocomplete feature, and let's assume I have no idea what to do. Then I will start again with the ID, and I will just perform the test, the steps I like to test for. So I will type something in, then I use my arrow keys to navigate down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I press enter. And that's what I like to test for. Now I export those tests again. Now let's see what we have here. And I copy just those tests and put it here. Now, because I have a GUnit test, I want to add an assertion. So I need an indicator that I'm now on the right page. I will look into the URL, and maybe, I don't know, maybe there are some random parts in it, but I think that this part may be a good indicator for the right page. So I will add an assertion. So now I ask the driver for the URL. Get current URL. And those URL should contain the string I just copied. Now let's test. And, well, if I have a small tip for you, don't blink when I click on run, because you may miss the test. Depending on the page, it's sometimes really fast. Now the test fails, and the output of the ID has some problems. So first, I was not typing in boxing gloss, but I was typing in box. And as you can see, the ID didn't record the keys I pressed, so I have to manually add them. So I will now add keys dot arrow down, and I pressed arrow down 5 times, so I added 2, 3, 4, 5 times, and then I pressed enter, so I will include another line where I make it to press enter. So now let's try again. Now it fails again. And maybe you see what the problem is. The problem is that the driver just went through all the steps and then tested for the URL, but it didn't wait for the autocomplete menu to open. So now I'm going to fix this. I can't memorize the command, but I will use those wait command. I will include it here. And now the question is, what is the condition to wait for? So the command tells the driver to wait for at most 10 seconds or until special condition holds. Now let's have a look at those condition. I need to activate the developer tools. So here I have the autocomplete menu. And then I will use this to find this in the code. And maybe you can see it. This is the whole autocomplete menu, where I could decide to take one of the sub-elements. So what if you see? Now this part is not visible and it says style display none. And if it is visible, then it says style display block. So I will add a wait command for the element with this ID, because I think the ID might be a good point to identify this element. And I will tell the driver to wait for this element to have a special style. So I'm telling it to that there shall be the attribute shall contain something. It shall pick the element based on the ID, which I just copied. And then, maybe as a reminder, the attribute is called style, and I want, if it's visible, then it is display block. So I wait for the attribute style to contain display block. And I need some more closing brackets. Here's some one too much. Now let's try again. Now the test fails again because we have the same problem as before. It waited for the autocomplete menu to open and then it moved to all the other steps, pressed enter, and then it checked for the URL, but before that it didn't wait for the page to change. So I will add another wait command. And this may seems to be a bit redundant, but I will tell it to wait until the URL contains the same string I'm checking for later. So this one, the assertion is for the JUnit that it can say that a test passes, and the driver wait, well, that's something else. It might seem a bit redundant, but they have two different purposes. So now let's try again. If it's done with loading. And the test succeeds, and now we have a first working running test example.